Most people can probably relate to this. When I was 7, my first exposure to dinosaurs was through a Jurassic Park movie in the late 2010s. My kid brain blown away. Like, these things walk on Earth. I really wanna see one. But then an adult ruined it. It hit me with cold truth. It's just science fiction. Dinosaurs are extinct. And just like that, my excitement got yeeted into the void. But now that I'm older and mildly obsessed with animals, I realize dinosaurs never went extinct. They just got feathers, lost their PR war, and became chicken. That's right, every time you eat KFC, you are eating some T-Rex's cousin, boneless projectile with sauce. But wait, what if I told you we can make every childhood's dream come true? A real-life Jurassic Park. Not in the future, not in VR, right now. A park full of real dinosaurs and modern reptiles that look like they rolled straight out of the Cretaceous and way scarier than CGI. But hold up, let's rewind. What even is a dinosaur? Because somewhere along the line, pop culture decided dinosaurs were only the chunky reptilian giants from a Steven Seagal movie. Basically, anything with teeth, claws, and a tail that could slap a jeep into orbit. But scientifically, dinosaurs isn't about size or vibes, it's about the hips. Yeah, hips don't lie, and evolution's been playing that song since the Triassic. Dinosaurs have their legs positioned directly under their bodies, like a linebacker ready to tackle the Cretaceous. And birds check every box. Light bones? Check. Hollow air sacs? Check. Three-toed limbs? Check. Wishbone? Check. Feathers? That's not new. Velociraptors had that dream before, but check. In fact, if you dressed a naked chicken in a lizard costume and gave it a PR team, you'd probably call it a baby raptor. So no, dinosaurs didn't go extinct. They just shrunk, got a glow up, and now live in suburban bird feeders or ruin your car's paint job. But what about reptiles? You know, those cold-blooded creeps that make Florida unlivable. Reptiles are like the legacy software of evolution. Snakes, lizards, crocodiles, turtles, you name it. They've been around since before the dinosaurs, flexing their scaly dominance for over 300 million years. They were Earth's default setting. And at one point, they ran the show. We are talking giant sea serpents the size of buses, pterosaurs gliding over continents, and crocodiles so big they could probably eat you and your car and still be hungry. But reptiles are built different. Even though dinosaurs look reptilian, reptiles are not dinosaurs. But they are creatures of the old. They laid eggs, needed no daycare, didn't care about cuddles, and could probably survive with one brain cell and a sun lamp. But the real twist is, birds are reptiles too. When I first heard that birds are reptiles, I almost choked on a chicken nugget. Like, excuse me, reptiles are scaly, cold-blooded, and move like they forgot how knees work. Birds scream, fly, and poop mid-air out of spite. How is this the same animal? Did evolution hit copy-paste with a broken mouse? But plot twist, science doesn't care about vibes, it cares about clades. And under the phylogenetic classification, which is like the family tree from hell, birds don't just descend from dinosaurs, they are dinosaurs, theropods to be exact. Here's where it gets juicy. Dinosaurs are classified as reptiles and share a common ancestor with reptiles. Together, they form a group called Acosauria, a clade so old it watched the continents break up like a high school drama. And in modern biology, if you want to define reptilia correctly, you can't just include lizards, snakes, turtles, and crocodiles. Nope, you have to invite the birds to the party. And that brings me to a dumb idea I can't stop thinking about. What if we stop pretending dinosaurs are gone and start building a real Jurassic Park? Not the one with genetic mutants and insurance lawsuit. I mean a modern version, populated with living dinos and their ancient-looking cousins, reptiles. A living, breathing reincarnation of what Earth looked like for eons before mammals crashed the party. A place where cassowaries glare at you like prehistoric gatekeepers and monitor lizards bask like ancient dragons on rocks. A park where every screech, hiss, and flap isn't a museum relic. It's proof the past never left. We've just been walking through it this whole time without reading the signs. Okay, so imagine this. You wake up one day, look at the world and think, yeah, we've got malls, theme parks, and 18 versions of Spider-Man, but where's my real-life Dino Island? Not the one where billionaires clone monsters, forget to lock doors, and get eaten during brunch. I'm talking about a real, breathing, scaly, feathery, talon-wielding eco-park, a Jurassic reboot, but with actual surviving Jurassic cast. Not CGI, not genetic roulette, just a super group reunion of Earth's most unbothered survivors. But wait, why an island? Because we've seen the movies. When you put invasive species on the mainland, you get a Florida or Australia problem. One hurricane, one broken fence, and suddenly you've got Komodo dragons in your Taco Bell parking lot. That's how you end up in the news, not in a good way. So, make it a tropical island, big enough to contain chaos, but isolated enough to keep your HOA safe from a cassowary uprising. Think Kruger National Park or Sicily in size. We're not playing mini golf here. This isn't Bird World with flamingos and a sad goose. No, we are going full planet Earth on this thing. We start with three biomes because why not go full open world RPG? Welcome to the tropical forest biome. Mother Nature's pressure cooker. It's 90% humidity, 10% regret, and 100% prehistoric chaos. If your iPhone had a panic attack, it'd be here. This jungle is designed like a fruiting buffet for drama queens with wings. AKA, the forest should be full of fruiting and nutting trees, with toucans roll up looking like walking skittles, taco, killbill, and channelbill. Hornbills arrive with headgear that says, I fight for fun. Macaws flash 90s rave color. And parrots like the Eclectus in African Grey act like feathered toddlers with a podcast. Jungle foes run around like chickens doing parkour. And curassows and tinamous walk like birds who skip leg day. Then there is the hot scene, aka a punk rock leaf digester with a cow's stomach. And the star of this biome, the cassowaries. Blue hairs, dagger feet, and zero chill. You don't walk past a cassowary, you sign a waiver. Up top, happy eagles, Philippine eagles, and crowned eagles fly around like Batman in molting season. Down below, reptiles flex. Chameleon color shift like moody LED lights. Basilisks walk on water. Monitor sneaks like ninjas. Tegus stomp like they pay rent. And iguanas, green, Antillean, and Fiji just slouch on branches like they forgot the plot. Up next, the grasslands. It's open, breezy, and peaceful until you see an ostrich. Basically, big bird on pre-workout. The emu, Australia's middle finger to military history. Rares, sprint like they commit tax fraud. Cory busters strut like beta CEOs. Crown cranes dance like fencing ballerinas. Ground hornbills stomp around like angry landlords. Turkeys and guinea fowls bring Mad Max energy, and quails dash like feathered stress ball. Peafowls, basically drag queens in molting couture. Cockatoos and galas party like they own the place. But don't blink, this place has reptiles that bench press fear. Komodo dragons if actual dragons had a glow down, and switch fire breath for poisonous drawl. Rock pythons, full body hug assassins. Secretary birds, high-heeled snake kickers. In the sky, tawny eagles, martial eagles, witch-tail eagles, and bateluas run the raptor mafia. Vultures and stork handle the cleanup, avian janitors with a god complex. And the star of this biome, the Galapagos tortoise. Old, wise, definitely judging you. Now welcome to the wetlands, nature's haunted basement. It's damp, it's buzzing, and everything looks like it's spawned from a DLC. A place where ducks flap like unpaid interns on caffeine, Muscovy, Mallard, Pacific Black, geese honk like car alarms, bareheaded, Egyptian and Chinese, Swans float in like angry ballerinas. Herons talk like detectives. Egrets stab fish with elegance. Spoonbills ladles with legs. Flamingos, drama queens on one foot, always ready to start a cult. Below the surface is fish, frogs, and the occasional scream. Crocodiles, caimans, and alligators. Prehistoric moboses in sperm mode. And the anaconda, just a muscular tube with no hobbies except swallowing regrets. But the real menace and the star of this biome, the shoebill stalk. A dinosaur cosplaying as a bird. If a T-Rex had a goat face, this is it. Now let's move on to the bigger picture. This park is not just a zoo, it's prehistoric fan fiction with a working ecosystem. Minimum human meddling except for ensuring the biomes are functional, like planting fruiting and nutting trees in the forest, cutting tree saplings in the grasslands, watering the wetlands and forests during dry season, and to fund the place through luxury ecotourism. But the rest? Maximum chaos. And no wild-caught birds here, because wild birds, they ghost you. 1 second in the aviary, next second flying to Africa because wanderlust is woven tightly in their DNA. So, we only take birds born in zoos, sanctuaries, aviaries, etc., etc. Creatures that think fences are just how the world works. But the animals in the park should run itself. Birds fertilize, reptiles keep order, predators vibe check the weak, and even dead things get recycled. So, is this even realistic? Honestly, kinda. If we can build fake islands for luxury hotels or PDF paradise, clone sheep and spend billions simping for space tourism, then yeah. Building a massive tropical wildlife park with birds and reptiles as nature's avengers isn't that wild. It's ambitious, sure, but we've done bigger and dumber things for less. But you can also build a Jurassic Park in your backyard too. Just keep fancy-looking chickens or pigeons and some iguanas and turtles in the mix, and boom, your backyard mirrors something prehistoric. And hey, if this video gets enough love, maybe someone like Mr. Beast sees it and goes, yeah, I'll build a Jurassic World. And if you like this chaotic fever dream of an idea, like it, share it, subscribe. And if you haven't already, check out our last video about relocating Asiatic lions back to Europe. And as always, stay curious, stay wild, and thank you very much for watching.